Before moving forward, let's have a little break and let's review the key concepts that we have seen, in which we defined a vector space, a tangent vector space here, and a tangent vector space here. And we were using a map, which is the push forward, to push a vector from here to here. And this is a map, okay? So you see, we start with a vector here, and we arrive at another vector through our mapping phi star, so our push forward that is leaving on the tangent space on the other manifold. Then we had our pullback that allowed us to pull back a vector at one form leaving on the dual tangent space on the manifold M prime to the dual tangent space of the manifold M, which is this one. So we are using the push forward to go from V to phi star of F, sorry, to phi star of F, and we are using the pullback to go from the one form phi W to the pullback of W. And the two are defined such that you have a consistency within the two sides. Then what we did was to express our definition for the push forward and the pullback in terms of a charting, and we were using the full charting that was insisting that was on which we that were mapping the two manifolds. Okay. And with that, we realized in the end that our push forward is a generalization of a coordinate transformation once you introduce the charts for the two manifolds. You now understand that you have two ways to see at this problem. One, which is passive, if you want to call it so, in which we are just interpreting this transformation from V to the push forward of our vector as a passive coordinate transformation. So you define the two charts, and what you are going to do is just to re-express the coefficients of your vectors in terms of different coefficients. And with that, you understand that this is the function that is performing this coordinate transformation, which is everything based on phi, on the chart between the two manifolds. And you understand that if I would choose a different function phi from a point P, I might arrive in a different location on the other manifold. And once I do, I apply my chart, I'm arriving at some different coordinates here. So you see, phi defines the coordinate transformations. Therefore, you have a relationship one-to-one between the transformation given by your mapping between the two manifolds and the coordinate transformation, because this guy is the guy that's telling you where you are arriving on a manifold, and therefore which kind of coefficients, once you define the chart, you are going to obtain. The other one is sort of an active view, in which you can think at the starting vector and at the arrival vector as two different things. Okay? So you are kind of transforming your vector through the map given by the pull, the, by, given the, by the push forward, with the constraint that the behavior of this vector on the tangent space on M here and of this vector on the tangent space of the manifold M prime are actually behaving the same with respect to the one forms that are leaving into the two respective tangent spaces. Okay? So you have this consistency. So one, and you have these two views. One is as a sort of generalized coordinate transformation. This will be your passive approach in which you are changing the frames. And the other one is active, in which you are building up two different, you can think of them as two different objects, but they are behaving on the two different manifolds in the same way with respect to the one forms that are there. And now I'm just speaking about vector and one form because is the simplest tensor that we can think of, but the same procedure applies to tensors of different kind.